We will start all CNS drugs, the drugs which are acting on central nervous system, okay? So before understanding the drugs on central nervous system, we should understand some basic things. I will start with all basic things. Once basic is clear, then you can easily understand the pharmacology, drugs, adverse effects, and their clinical significance. So before understanding the central nervous system drugs, let me first tell you about neurotransmitters. Neurotransmitter. Do you know what is a neurotransmitter, anybody? What is neurotransmitter? Anybody from the class? Can anyone define what is neurotransmitter? So these are the endogenous compounds or endogenous chemical substances which will try to stimulate or which will try to transfer the information from the brain to the tissues or from the one neuron to the other neuron. Okay? So just to understand, I'll try to make you very easy. Just imagine this is brain. Okay? Brain is made up of many nerves. Okay? Brain is totally made up of nerves. And there are some nerves which are innervating into the tissues. This is brain and this is spinal cord. Okay, spinal cord. And from the brain and spinal cord, we have so many nerve fibers. We have so many nerve fibers from the brain, which is innervating into the tissues. Okay, so the nerves, actually in nerves, we have somatic nerves and autonomic nerves. Mostly somatic nerves are sensory nerves. And in autonomic nerves, we have sympathetic and parasympathetic. All that things I'll try to explain in next classes. Our topic is mainly discussing about central nervous system. That means we will be mainly focusing on brain and spinal cord. Okay, let me draw one single nerve fiber which is located in brain. Let me draw single nerve which is located in brain, or the nerve which is coming from the brain and directly attaching to the tissue. The nerve which is originating from the brain and directly attaching to the tissue. Okay, so let me draw one single nerve now. See, this is a nerve. Actually, the nerves will have some branches. Okay, and the nerve which is located at the brain or which is very near to the brain, they are considered as presynaptic nerve. And the nerve fiber which is connecting from the presynaptic nerve to the tissue or which is present away from the brain, they are called postsynaptic nerve fiber or postsynaptic nerve. And in between there is a junction which is called synaptic cleft or synapse, which is a synapse, right? So neurotransmitters are the endogenous compounds or chemicals which are synthesized. They are stored and released by either nerves or brain, particularly nerves. Brain is nothing but nerves, no? Brain is the tissue which is made up of nerves. So in the nerves, the neurotransmitters are synthesized, they are stored, and they are released. So when neurotransmitter is synthesized, that neurotransmitters will go and it will be stored in vesicles. Just they are the granules, small granules or single layered vesicle. In that vesicle, the neurotransmitter will be stored. Starting, the neurotransmitter got synthesized. Okay, in synthesis there will be certain processes. I will not explain about that all. It is not required. After its synthesis, that neurotransmitter will be stored in the synapse. It will be stored in the vesicle, right? And when the neurotransmitter is stored in the synapse, sometimes what happens? The presynaptic nerve or the nerve will be stimulated. The nerve will be stimulated. Who will stimulate the nerve? On every nerve membrane, we have some sodium and potassium channels, particularly sodium channels. It is having sodium channels. So when the sodium channels are opened, sodium will try to enter into the nerve. Sodium ions will try to enter into the nerve. When sodium enters into the nerve, what happens? The positive ion concentration. Sodium is a cation, right? Sodium, potassium, calcium. Yaad rakhlo, sodium, potassium and calcium, Ca+2. So these are cations. When any of these cations, from these three, any of the cation tries to enter into the cell, what will happen? The positive ion concentration into the cell increases. Do you know, if positive ion concentration in the cell increases, that is called depolarization. If positive ion concentration increases in the nerve, that is called depolarization. What happens if cell is depolarized? Depolarized means the cell will be contracted. Okay, the cell will be contracted. Yahan pe this cell, this presynaptic nerve, what will happen? This nerve will be contracted. When nerve contracts, when this nerve contracts, the vesicle which is filled with neurotransmitter, what it happens, it will be squeezed and the neurotransmitter will ooze out. The neurotransmitter will eject out. When neurotransmitter, yes, Prajwal? Yes, deep. See, whenever depolarization occurs, depolarization is nothing but squeezing of the nerve or contraction of the nerve or contraction of the cell. Depolarization is nothing but, we can say it is stimulation. Depolarization means stimulation, contraction or squeezing. Okay? Depolarization means contraction. Yaad rakhlo, simple. Whatever it is, muscle cell or nerve cell or anything. So when depolarization occurs, what happens? The neurotransmitter which is filled in the vesicle will be squeezed and it will release outside. When it is releasing into the synapse, in the synapse on the postsynaptic nerve, we have certain receptors. They are called neurotransmitter receptors or neurotransmitter, we can call them as simply receptors, nerve receptors. And when this neurotransmitter is falling on this receptor, further it will show its action. So receptor ke, in receptors we have some receptors are excitatory receptors, some of them are inhibitory receptors. In that, each receptor will be showing different action upon activating by different neurotransmitter. Okay, about the different classes of neurotransmitters, I'm going to explain now. You just try to understand what is neurotransmitter. Neurotransmitter is a endogenous ingredient or endogenous chemical compound which is synthesized, stored and released by the nerves or brain. Clear? You understood what is neurotransmitter, right? And in neurotransmitters, we have some examples. Neurotransmitters ke andar examples kya hai? There is a very simple neurotransmitter called glutamate. Sab log yaad rakh lo, glutamate. There is another neurotransmitter called GABA, gamma amino butyric acid, GABA. There is another neurotransmitter called acetylcholine, ACH, acetylcholine. We have glycine, GLYCINE, glycine. We have noradrenaline. We have aspartate. So these are all the examples of neurotransmitters, right? Now I am going to explain you what the types of neurotransmitters and what they will show actions in the body. Okay? So you understood what is neurotransmitter and some examples of neurotransmitters, right? So in neurotransmitters, let me try to make you more clear. Let me try to classify neurotransmitters. Neurotransmitters, I told you different names, but you should remember, no? See, in neurotransmitters, we have some neurotransmitters are excitatory in nature. Excitatory. T-O-R-Y. Excitatory means if a neurotransmitter releases at particular point and if it binds on the receptor, so it will try to excite central nervous system. Anyways, listen now. Everybody try to listen. See, when glutamate and aspartate releases in our body, what it does, it causes CNS stimulation, right? This is clear. So when patient has CNS stimulant activity, or when patient is having CNS stimulation, whenever patient is having CNS stimulation, what are the clinical presentations or what will be the signs and symptoms of the patient? So no, especially what will be the symptoms in the patients? Patient may symptoms kya rehte? When excitatory neurotransmitter is released in the body and when CNS stimulation is occurred, the patient will be having these symptoms. See, listen carefully. Number one, patient will have excitation. Excitation means, see, excitation is a type of feeling when you are playing certain games and immediately you won. So how will be your feeling? You are super excited, right? You will be whistling, you will be running, dancing, jumping. Okay, so you will be enjoying that situation. So that kind of situation is called excitement. So when CNS is stimulated, first symptom or first clinical presentation is patient will have excitation. Over-excitation bhi achha nahi hai. Okay, excitation thodi der ke liye, okay. But over-excitation has many other lethal consequences. That also I'll tell. So first clinical presentation, if CNS is stimulated, is excitation. Number two. Sab log dhyan se sunna. Number two, patient will have euphoria. Euphoria is also a type of excitement. But in euphoria, patient will enjoy. Patient will be whistling. Patient will be dancing. And patient will be singing. Khali pehli patient without entertaining others. Man mein singing karte rehta patient. Bathroom mein kabhi kabhi apan paani naate time pe, simply what we do, if we imagine about something good things, we will start singing ourselves. Or when we are alone, what we will do? We will be singing, dancing ourselves. So that is called euphoric symptom, euphoria. So euphoria is the second symptom of CNS stimulation. Are you all following me? Awaaz barabar aa rahi hai sab logon ko? Very good. Ab dekho, third clinical presentation when CNS is stimulated, patient will have third clinical presentation when patient is having CNS stimulation is insomnia. You know what is insomnia? Can anyone tell me what it is? Very good. Improper sleep or loss of sleep. Sleep aati nahi. Ab dekho, you are super excited and your CNS system is highly stimulated. At that time, you will not get sleep. Aapke, what we say, if there are certain situations where you are very happy or where you are so much excited. For example, if your brothers or if someone's marriage is happening, for example, aapke brothers ya whatever, close relatives ke, close friend ke marriage ke time pe, you are super excited, no? At that time, whole night you will not sleep. Whole night you will be dancing, you will be singing, you will be entertaining, ye sab karte rehte, okay? So in that conditions, in stimulatory conditions, patient will not get sleep. Insomnia is another clinical presentation. Sab log yaad karne ki koshish karo. And number four, patient will have tremors. This is very rarely seen, patient will have tremors. Tremors means haath pair kaamte rehte. Excitation also can cause tremors. Ek bar dar se excitement aata, ek bar happiness ke wajah se excitement aata, ek bar anxiety ke wajah se bhi excitement aata, okay? So all these are seen as stimulatory reactions. Immediately if you see a snake or immediately if you see some wild animals chasing you, when you see some dogs, wild dogs chasing at you, situation kaisi rehti? CNS super excited ho jata, stimulate ho jata, wahan se bhagne ki koshish karoge, haath aap pair pure kaamna lag jate, okay? So patient will have tremors. And patient will have tremors means patient also will have tachycardia. Always remember, tremors are always what we say, it is interlinked with tachycardia means increased heart rate, okay? And sometimes patient will have twitching means immediate contractions of the muscles contract hoke relax hota twitchings. And sometimes patient will have convulsions. Very, very, very important point. Convulsions. Fifth one is twitching. And sixth one is patient will have convulsions. What is convulsion? Very good. Seizure is, okay. Seizure bol sakte, convulsions or fits. Convulsions or fits. Tremors agar jyada ho gaya, to patient will have tremors. Tremor jyada ho gaya, to patient will have convulsions. Convulsions means haath pair pure. Rapid contractions of muscles will occur and patient will have fits. Hatha pairam pure maar leta patient aur gir jata niche. Okay, so that is convulsions. Over excitation or over CNS stimulation can also cause convulsions. Actually, convulsion is the very, very important clinical presentation in excitatory activity. Kabhi bhi patient ke body ke andar, if glutamate neurotransmitter or aspartate neurotransmitter is elevated, patient will have excitation, patient will have euphoria, patient will have insomnia, patient will have tremors, tachycardia, twitching, and patient will have convulsions. Clear everybody? These are very, very important CNS clinical presentations when patient is having excitatory neurotransmitter activity. In excitatory neurotransmitters, we have glutamate and we have aspartate. And see, if this glutamate and aspartate is further increased, convulsions ke baad phir se excitation got increased, CNS stimulation further increased, what will happen? Convulsion ke baad patient will go to coma. And if this coma, from coma again, if the same CNS stimulation is elevated, finally patient will die. Death is the final clinical presentation. Death is the final action that can be seen if glutamate and aspartate is highly increased in the body. सबको समझ में आ गया? Excitatory neurotransmitter which will cause CNS stimulation, and in excitatory neurotransmitters we have glutamate and aspartate, and when glutamate and aspartate increases in the body, it will show all these actions. How many of you understood this point? आवाज बराबर आ रही सब लोगों को? Yes, very good. आप देखो. Now I would like to add one more point here. There are some drugs which will try to increase either glutamate activity or aspartate activity. or there are some drugs without increasing aspartate activity and without increasing glutamate activity, they will directly cause CNS stimulation. This is very, very important point. Aap dekho, we have understood about excitatory neurotransmitters, right? Agar excitatory neurotransmitters badh gaye to kya hota, we understood. Now, there are some drugs which will try to show same actions like glutamate and aspartate, either by increasing glutamate concentration or aspartate concentration, or these drugs may directly cause stimulation on the central nervous system. By that, it will show excitatory actions. In that, what we have, there is a very, very famous drug called amphetamines. Amphetamines, sune naam aap? Amphetamines. Iske baare mein detail mein samjhaunga. I will explain about amphetamines, about pharmacokinetics, pharmacodynamics, its adverse effects, drug interactions, and what important counseling points to be given to the patient, indications and contraindications. So, amphetamine is one class of drug which will show excitatory actions. Number two, there is another drug. Sometimes in amphetamine we have cocaine. Sune naam cocaine kabhi? How many of you heard about cocaine? Have you heard about cocaine? Yes. And there are some other drugs. Yaad rakhlo, yahan pe new drugs will be coming. Try to remember those drugs. There is a drug called, I'll try to write the spelling here, armodafinil. Sab log, I am explaining particularly for PharmD second year students. Armodafinil. We have armodafinil and we have modafinil. There are two drugs, armodafinil and modafinil. These drugs, what they do, they don't alter glutamate and aspartate concentrations in the body, but directly they will show CNS stimulation action. Armodafinil and modafinil. Clear? Armodafinil and modafinil are the drugs which will show CNS stimulation activity. Ladita, are you following me? This kind of drugs will be appearing in QCHP, okay? You will not find these drugs in our pharmacology textbooks, in classifications. I think you are following me. Ladita, are you there? Are, okay, chalo, koi baat nahi. Armodafinil and modafinil, clear? And next. Have you heard about methylphenidate? How many of you heard about methylphenidate? Methylphenidate. How many of you heard about methylphenidate? Anybody from PBS? Third year? You didn't heard about methylphenidate? Methylphenidate is also, this is a neuro drug. And these drugs are approved by FDA for narcolepsy. I will tell that point also. Okay? Chalo, methylphenidate is another drug. They will show excitatory action on CNS system. And there is another drug called Oxybate. O-X-Y-B-A-T-E, Oxybate. There are certain drugs called Abate, Acephate. These kind of drugs are OP drugs. These drugs are not CNS stimulants. These are CNS depressants actually. Abate, Acephate, yaad rakhlo. This is Oxybate, O-X-Y-B-A-T-E. Okay. Actually, this Oxybate, purane jamane mein, it was used as local anesthetic. It was used as anesthesia. It is used as anesthetic agent. But mainly it is CNS stimulant. There is another drug called Pitolisat. See, stimulant action is seen in central nervous system. And it will show anesthetic action on peripheral nerves. See, stimulant action is different and anesthesia is totally different. I will explain you while explaining about anesthesia also. Iske baad wahi aayega. Okay? See, central nervous system mein everything comes. Once you learn about all these drugs and when I try to explain about anesthesia, you'll come to know. Okay? Don't worry. See, actually anesthetic agents, what they do, they'll stop the sodium channels at particular nerves, and through that it will stop the movement of neurotransmitters from one place to another place. Actually, uska mechanism alagi hai. I'll explain. Don't worry. Okay? You will get clarity. Not now. We are confused. Ho jayega. Okay? Anyways, this is ek cheez yaad rakhlo. There are some drugs. See, cocaine also here. Cocaine also will show anesthetic action. Do you know this point? Cocaine also shows anesthetic action, but in central nervous system, it will show euphoric action and it will show excitation and it will show pleasant feeling. Okay, इसके बारे में मैं डिटेल में समझा दूँ आपको, एक एक ड्रग के बारे में डिटेल में समझा दूँ, डोंट वरी. अभी आई एम जस्ट गिविंग यू दी ओवरव्यू. सो द सिक्स्थ ड्रग इज पिटोलिस्टैट. पिटोलिसेंट. ये ड्रग्स याद रख लो, फिर बाद में कभी नहीं सुने थे करके नहीं बोलना. आई एम रिपीटिंग द नेम्स ऑफ द ड्रग्स. सो दैट एटलीस्ट यू विल लिसन वंस इन योर लाइफ. ये ड्रग्स कहीं भी नहीं मिलेंगे आपको. सो CNS स्टिमुलेंट्स के ड्रग्स. एंड वन मोर इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट, ऑल दिस ड्रग्स व्हाट आई एम प्रोनाउंसिंग, नो, दिस ड्रग्स आर नॉट कॉमनली यूज्ड इन हॉस्पिटल्स. दे विल बी यूजुअली कमिंग हियर एंड देयर ओनली इन कॉम्पिटेटिव एग्जाम्स एंड इन रेयर केसेस, रेयर सिचुएशंस में देते. एटलीस्ट बींग ए क्लिनिकल फार्मासिस्ट, वी शुड अंडरस्टैंड द लिथल ड्रग्स, यूजफुल ड्रग्स, नॉन यूजफुल ड्रग्स, सब एटलीस्ट एक बार उसके बारे में पता रहना अपने को. क्लियर? क्लियर? आर यू ऑल फॉलोइंग मी? चलो अब देखो, वी वर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट एक्साइटेटरी न्यूरो ट्रांसमीटर्स एंड इन एक्साइटेटरी न्यूरो ट्रांसमीटर्स ग्लूटामेट एस्पार्टेट आर द एग्जाम्पल्स एंड देर आर सर्टेन ड्रग्स विच विल ट्राई टू एक्साइट CNS सिस्टम. दे आर कॉल्ड CNS स्टिमुलेंट्स. इन दैट एम्फेटामाइन्स आर वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. कोकाइन, आर्मोडाफिनिल, मोडाफिनिल, मिथाइल फिनिडेट, ऑक्सीबेट एंड ये क्या था, पिटोलिसेंट. ओके, पिटोलिसेंट. सो दिज आर द ड्रग्स विच आर यूजली कंसिडर्ड एज CNS stimulants. Clear till here everybody. Now I will talk about CNS depressants. See, there are certain neurotransmitters which will also show inhibitory actions in the central nervous system. See, apne ko neurotransmitters, first neurotransmitters, what they do, they will show excitations. Excitatory neurotransmitters, we have discussed about glutamate and aspartate. And second category of neurotransmitters, they are inhibitory neurotransmitters. And third category of neurotransmitters, they are having both excitatory and inhibitory actions. Excitatory and inhibitory actions. Now, we are discussing about the neurotransmitters which are considered as inhibitory neurotransmitters. Inhibitory neurotransmitter. Can anyone tell me a very famous inhibitory neurotransmitter? Anybody from the class? Very good. Excellent. GABA. Very, very famous. GABA. Gamma aminobutyric acid. This is one inhibitory neurotransmitter. And any other neurotransmitter you know about inhibitory neurotransmitters? There is another neurotransmitter called glycine. Glycine. It is a simple amino acid. Glycine. And dopamine. Actually, if dopamine is converted into noradrenaline, it will show excitatory actions in autonomic nerves. Whereas dopamine in central nervous system, it will show inhibitory actions. Yaad rakhlo. Agar dopamine noradrenaline convert ho gaya, this noradrenaline will try to show some excitatory actions on autonomic nerves or on the CNS system. But dopamine, what it does, it will show inhibitory actions. Clear? So try to remember these three names. The inhibitory neurotransmitters, what they do? Inhibitory neurotransmitters will try to depress central nervous system. The inhibitory neurotransmitters, what they do? They will try to depress central nervous system. Clear this point? Ab dekho. Ab mujhe aayega dekho. Sab log dhyan se suno. Everybody are listening to me? Are you all listening to me? Yes. Ab dekho. Agar apne body ke andar GABA, glycine aur dopamine bad gaya to kya hoga? CNS depression hoga. Yes or no? CNS डिप्रेशन होगा, यस आर नो? सो अगर किसी भी पेशेंट में CNS डिप्रेशन होगा तो व्हाट विल बी दी क्लिनिकल प्रेजेंटेशंस और व्हाट विल बी दी साइंस एंड सिम्टम्स? CNS डिप्रेशन में क्या क्या होगा, ध्यान से सुनो सब लोग, ध्यान से सुनो. नंबर वन, पेशेंट विल हैव ड्राउजीनेस. ड्राउजीनेस मीन्स क्लास सुनते सुनते सो जाना और व्हाट वी से यानिंग ऑल द टाइम. यानिंग मीन्स माउथ खोल के यानिंग करते रहते ना जी. हाँ, उसको गुजराती में क्या बोलते हैं, व्हाट वी कॉल इन हिंदी, जमाई लेना. सो दिस इज कॉल्ड ड्राउजीनेस. नॉट शोइंग इंटरेस्ट, सिंपली ट्राइंग टू फील स्लीप, ये सब ड्राउजीनेस के अंडर आते हैं. ओके, सो ड्राउजीनेस इज वन क्लिनिकल प्रेजेंटेशन. एंड नंबर टू, patient will have sedation. Patient will have sedation. What is the difference between drowsiness and sedation? What is the difference between drowsiness and sedation? Drowsiness is not... Yes, body active nahi rahega. Sleep aate rehta, weak rehta. All muscles will be relaxed. Patient is about to sleep. And sedation is patient is ready to sleep. This is about to sleep and this is ready to sleep. And there is another condition. There is another concept called hypnosis. 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 Simple kaisa yaad kar lete bole to. Drowsiness is about to sleep. Sedation is feeling to sleep. And hypnosis is directly slept. Patient so jata isme. Hypnosis means patient will sleep. So these symptoms of CNS depression. Aur suno. There is another symptom. Disorientation. Disorientation means. Focus. Okay. Or how can you justify disorientation? How can you define disorientation? Anybody from the class? Loss of coordination. Unable to stand properly. Unable to walk properly. Okay. और दारू पीने के बाद पेशेंट कैसा फील होते रहता है, ज़्यादा दारू पी लिए तो. इन मूवीज यू माइट हैव सीन, थकते रहता पेशेंट, इधर उधर गिरते रहता, बराबर से चलते नहीं रहता. दैट इज कॉल्ड डिसोरिएंटेशन. पेशेंट कांट स्टैंड प्रॉपरली. एक्चुअली डिसोरिएंटेशन इज नॉट ओनली सीन इन इनहिबिटरी एक्शंस. इन डिसोरिएंटेशन इज नॉट ओनली सीन इफ पेशेंट इज अल्कोहलिक. डिसोरिएंटेशन कैन ऑल्सो बी सीन इन सम नर्व डिसफंक्शन कंडीशन. ओके, इसके बारे में भी मैं डिटेल में बताऊंगा आपको. डिसोरिएंटेशन इज जस्ट, इट इज ए सिम्टम वेयर पेशेंट इज अनेबल टू स्टैंड और वॉक प्रॉपरली. क्लियर? Next, so this is another presentation. We can see if CNS is depressed. Now, one more very important point. In CNS depression, patient will have unconsciousness sometimes. Unconsciousness. Patient will have unconsciousness. And sometimes patient will not show any interest in education. Patient will not show interest in playing. Patient will not show any interest in any doing activities. Activities karne mein interest nahi dikhayega. Kab, when patient is having CNS depression. And finally, if this CNS depression activity is increased, patient will go to coma. And if patient goes to coma, if CNS depression is again increased, finally patient will die. Patient will have death. So, dekho, CNS stimulation ke, CNS, when CNS is excited, ultimately at the end, patient will have coma and patient will die. Patient will be having death. In CNS stimulation actions and in CNS inhibitory action also, at the end, patient will go to coma and patient will die. So, over-excitation also can cause coma and over-inhibition also can cause coma. Over-excitation also can cause death and over-inhibition also can cause death. Clear everybody? Samajh mein aa gaya sab logon ko? Are you all following me? Awaaz aa rahi hai aap logon ko? Yes, ab maja aayega dekho. There are some drugs which will show CNS depression actions. There are some drugs which will show CNS depression. Can anyone tell me the drugs which will act like GABA, glycine and dopamine? Or the drugs will directly inhibit CNS system and they will show CNS depression. Can anyone tell me some examples of drugs which... Some batterin you told. What? Sudhanshu? Digabatrin. Vigabatrin is anti-epileptic drug. Okay, it will show CNS depression action. Okay, very good. Vigabatrin. We can say all anti-epileptic drugs. Ye anti-epileptic drugs ke baare mein apan detail mein padhenge. But see, Shivani was telling something. Shivani, barbiturates, very good. Barbiturates, we have certain class of drugs called barbiturates. Barbiturates ke baare mein detail mein padhte apan. Barbiturates, yeah. Diazepam is not a, it is a drug. I am asking you the classes. Benzodiazepines, very good. Benzodiazepines are CNS depressants. And any other drug? We have opiates, very good. Opiates or do you have any other CNS depressants? Do you have any CNS depressants? Alcohol. Yes? No, not anesthetics. Anesthetics we can consider, but no. In CNS, direct action nahi hoga uska. Okay? Antipsychotics, wo barbiturate benzodiazepines mein aaye jayega. Tricyclic antidepressants. Okay? Tricyclic antidepressants mein some drugs, not all drugs. There are some drugs which will also show CNS depressant action. Isme yaad rakh lo, barbiturates and benzodiazepines. Barbiturates, benzodiazepines, opiates, alcohol, and very, very important drug. They are not direct CNS depressants, but they are having that action. In that we have antihistamines. Have you heard about antihistamines? Antihistamines, sune, second year wale sune antihistamines. How, where you heard antihistamines, Prajwal, where you heard? कहाँ सुने? अच्छा अच्छा ओके चलो. सो नॉट ओनली दिस ड्रग्स, नॉट ओनली बारबिट्यूरेट्स, बेंजोडिआजेपिन्स, ओपिएट्स, अल्कोहल, एंटीस्टामिन्स, देयर आर सम अदर ड्रग्स आल्सो, बट मेनली यू हैव टू कंसीडर दिस ड्रग्स एज सीएनएस डिप्रेसेंट्स. ओके सो वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट एक्साइटेटरी न्यूरोट्रांसमीटर्स. What are the clinical presentations if excitatory neurotransmitters releases? In that examples we have seen about inhibitory neurotransmitters, GABA, glycine, dopamine. What happens if inhibitory neurotransmitter occurs CNS depression, and in CNS depression what will be the signs and symptoms, particularly clinical presentations. And we have also seen some drugs which will show same action like GABA, glycine. And here one more thing we forgot, GABA analogs. Simply GABA analogs, there are some drugs which will directly show action on GABA, and they are called GABA agonist or GABA analogs or GABA mimetics. Okay, so they are also considered as CNS depressants. Now we will try to see the third category of neurotransmitters are showing both excitatory and inhibitory actions. In that, what we have a very, very important neurotransmitter which is called serotonin. Yaad rakhlo, serotonin iske bare mein detail mein padhenge apan, which is also called 5-hydroxytryptamine. 5-HT bolte, 5-HT. Have you heard about 5-HT? Yes, 5-hydroxytryptamine. In that we have so many types, we have so many receptors, and we have serotonin. Okay, serotonin is also called 5-hydroxytryptamine or 5-HT. So serotonin is one neurotransmitter which will show both excitatory actions and inhibitory actions. Wo excitation kab dikhayega, inhibition kab dikhayega, I will tell you while explaining about serotonin. Okay, and next we have noradrenaline is another neurotransmitter which will show both excitations and inhibitory actions. And number 3, we have acetylcholine, ACH. Acetylcholine is also another neurotransmitter which will show both excitations and inhibitory actions. So these are different classes of drugs. Neurotransmitters. Neurotransmitters ke baare mein kuch idea aaya aap logon ko? Did you get it? I think you got some basic idea about neurotransmitters. Yes? Yes? So, अब और मजा आएगा. देखो सुनो सब लोग, आर यू ऑल फॉलोइंग मी एवरीबडी अनम्यूट योर माइक एंड गिव मी द आंसर. ओके ओनली सुधांशु, विक्की एंड प्रज्वल, शिवानी और आंसरिंग. क्रीना, आर यू स्लीपिंग? आई थिंक क्रीना इज. ओके डोंट फील दैट माई लेक्चर, माई वॉइस एज ए सीएनएस डिप्रेशन, आई मीन इनहिबिटरी रिएक्शंस नहीं दिख रहा ना, मेरा वॉइस सुनते ही सब लोग एक्साइट हो जाते. That's why my voice is always like excitatory neurotransmitter. Anyways, चलो अब देखो सुनो सब लोग, अब यहाँ पे सुनो सब लोग. Till now we have classified neurotransmitters in 3 formats. Number 1, excitatory neurotransmitters, inhibitory neurotransmitters, and the neurotransmitter which are having both excitatory and inhibitory. Okay, so this classification we have seen. Now we will try to classify neurotransmitters based on their chemical structure. Based on their chemical structure, this is very easy. See, some neurotransmitters are simple amino acids. In that we have glycine and glutamate, both G's. Glycine and glutamate are amino acids, and we have certain neurotransmitters which are called amines or monoamines or catecholamines. Catecholamines. Actually, in catecholamines are those which are having catechol nucleus in their chemical structure and amines. Okay, monoamines bolte. So in catecholamines we have adrenaline, noradrenaline. We have dopamine, and sometimes serotonin. Okay. So all these are catecholamines. Okay, based I'm actually explaining you the classification of neurotransmitters based on their chemical structure. Okay, amino acids ke kon hai, amino acids ke kon, why I'm explaining this, you know, why it is important, you know, while giving or while using these drugs or these amino acids, you should understand. Pharmacokinetics में आपको use होगा. Amino acids कभी भी अपन oral route से नहीं देते. And their properties also, it is very easy if by understanding their chemical structure. Okay, वो भी आपको detail में समझा दूँ. Amino acids देख लिए, catecholamines देख लिए. Now there are some neurotransmitters which are available as peptides. Now Shivani will tell what is the difference between amino acid and peptide. Very good. See, some neurotransmitters are simple amino acid. That means they are made up of single amino acid. Glycine, it is a simple amino acid. Glutamate, it is also single amino acid. But there are some neurotransmitters which are not having single amino acid but group of amino acids. In that, can anyone tell me the examples? Let me see who will tell. GABA, gamma amino acid, it is neither amino acid nor it is polypeptide. Yes, anybody? Insulin is a polypeptide, but insulin is not neurotransmitter. Insulin is not neurotransmitter. Insulin is not released from nerves. In today's class, we are discussing about the chemical constituents which are released from nerves. Okay? Ab dekho, peptides ke andar neurotransmitters kya hai? Have you heard about substance P? Substance P? How many? Bolo substance P ke baare mein, bolo Sudhanshu. Substance P ka action. Anybody from the class, can anyone tell me what is the function or what is the basic action of substance P? In last class, I was explaining. वासो कंस्ट्रक्शन कॉज करता है, आर यू श्योर? सब्सटेंस पी कॉजेस वासो डायलेशन. ओके, एंड वी हैव न्यूरोकाइनिन के. वी हैव न्यूरोकाइनिन 1, न्यूरोकाइनिन 2, न्यूरोकाइनिन पी. देर इज अनदर कॉम्पाउंड कॉल्स न्यूरोकाइनिन पी. एक्चुअली न्यूरोकाइनिन के अंदर बहुत सारे न्यूरोट्रांसमीटर्स है. ऑल दोज न्यूरोट्रांसमीटर्स आर वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट इन कॉजिंग माइग्रेन. माइग्रेन के टाइम पे आई विल एक्सप्लेन ऑल दिस थिंग्स. ओके, पेप्टाइड्स के अंदर क्या क्या है? पेप्टाइड्स के अंदर वी हैव सब्सटेंस पी, न्यूरोकाइनिन 1, न्यूरोकाइनिन 2, न्यूरोकाइनिन पी, न्यूरोकाइनिन आर, एंड वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट न्यूरोट्रांसमीटर, वी हैव सर्टेन एंडोजिनस ओपिएड न्यूरोट्रांसमीटर्स. यू नो हाउ मेनी ऑफ यू नो ओपिएड्स? Opiates which will release from our nervous system also. Our brain also releases certain peptides which will act on opioid receptors which are actually considered as... अरे नहीं, कहाँ से आ रहे हैं आप? कहाँ से जवाब दे रहे हैं? निकोटिनिक रिसेप्टर्स आर टोटली डिफरेंट. दे आर नॉट ओपियड रिसेप्टर्स. जैनब, कैन यू टेल द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ ओपियड रिसेप्टर्स? जैनब, आर यू देर? In last class, explain. Very good. Kappa receptors. We have mu receptors. Very good. Or इसके बारे में, opioids के बारे में जब detail में study करेंगे, अब confused हो जाओगे आप. Okay, so opioids, endogenous opioids are also another example of peptide neurotransmitters. Okay. Now अब देखो, अपन क्या देखें? Neurotransmitters के अंदर थोड़े amino acids है, थोड़े catecholamines है, थोड़े peptides है. And very very important, there are certain neurotransmitters which are also called gaso neurotransmitters. अभी तक कोई सुने नहीं होंगे gaso neurotransmitters. सुने कोई? How many of you heard about gaso neurotransmitters? अगर कोई फिफ्थ ईयर वाले, पीबी वाले, सेकंड ईयर वाले, थर्ड ईयर वाले, फोर्थ ईयर वाले, इफ यू वांट टू राइट रिव्यू पेपर, यू कैन राइट ऑन गैसो न्यूरोट्रांसमीटर्स. एंड यू आल्सो कैन राइट अबाउट दिस पेप्टाइड्स. यू कैन राइट अबाउट दिस पेप्टाइड्स एंड देयर सिग्निफिकेंस इन माइग्रेन. यू कैन राइट अबाउट कैटेकोलामाइंस. ओके, यू कैन राइट अबाउट द स्टिमुलेटरी न्यूरोट्रांसमीटर्स, एक्जैक्टली व्हाट दे आर कॉजिंग इन द बॉडी. उसके बहुत सारे रिसर्चर्स है. इसमें अब तक देखो, ऑल दिस न्यूरोट्रांसमीटर्स बेसिक एक्शन वी नो, बट अंदर और क्या क्या होता वी डोंट नो. ओके, there are so many things about brain, there are so many miracles about brain. Aadmi bipolar disorder karke rehta, suddenly patient will start laughing, and after some time suddenly patient will start crying, suddenly patient will be whistling, सडनली पेशेंट विल स्टार्ट क्राइंग. वो उस कंडीशन में न्यूरो ट्रांसमीटर, कौन सा न्यूरो ट्रांसमीटर में प्रॉब्लम है, क्यों ऐसा हो रहा, नो वन नोस. ऐसा नहीं बोलना कि पेशेंट को भूत लग गया करके, दैट इज वेरी बैड. ओके, इसके बारे में भी आई विल ट्राई टू एक्सप्लेन एवरीथिंग इन डिटेल. इट इज नॉट कि इफ यू डोंट अंडरस्टैंड न्यूरोलॉजिकल कंडीशन वी शुड नॉट ऑलवेज डिपेंड ऑन सुपर नेचुरल थिंग्स. ओके, एनी वेज, अब देखो, देर आर सर्टेन न्यूरो ट्रांसमीटर्स विच आर कॉल्ड गैसो न्यूरो ट्रांसमीटर्स और विच आर गैसेस, सिंपली विच आर गैसेस. सम न्यूरो ट्रांसमीटर्स विच आर इन गैशियस फॉर्म ऑल्सो विल शो लाइक न्यूरो ट्रांसमीटर एक्शन. एंड इन दैट वाट वी हैव, इन दैट वी हैव नाइट्रोजन ऑक्साइड. हैव यू हर्ड अबाउट नाइट्रोजन ऑक्साइड? नाइट्रोजन ऑक्साइड. हैव यू हर्ड अबाउट कार्बन मोनोऑक्साइड? कार्बन मोनोऑक्साइड. एंड देर इज अनदर कॉम्पाउंड कॉल्ड हाइड्रोजन सल्फाइड. हाइड्रोजन सल्फाइड, सुने नाम, हाइड्रोजन सल्फाइड, H2S. हाँ, वेरी गुड. हैव यू नो विक्की शर्मा, आप देखे? ओके, वेरी गुड, वेरी गुड. सो देखो, अब देखो, सुनो, अपने बॉडी के अंदर गैस और न्यूरो ट्रांसमीटर के क्लासिफिकेशन में वी हैव नाइट्रिक ऑक्साइड, वी हैव कार्बन मोनोऑक्साइड, एंड वी ऑल्सो हैव हाइड्रोजन सल्फाइड, H2S. सो दीज आर ऑल्सो कंसिडर्ड एज न्यूरो ट्रांसमीटर्स, बट दे आर गैशियस. इसके बारे में, नाइट्रोजन ऑक्साइड इज मेनली, इट इज शोइंग वासो डिलेटरी प्रॉपर्टी. एंड कार्बन मोनोऑक्साइड ऑल्सो समटाइम्स इट विल शो वाट वी से स्टिमुलेशन एंड डिप्रेशन एक्शन इन द नर्व्स. ओके, नर्व स्टिमुलेशन के लिए भी ये काम आता है. आई मीन इट इज रिलीज बाई अवर नर्व्स. एंड समटाइम्स H2S इज ऑल्सो रिलीज. वी शुड नॉट कन्फ्यूज विथ H2S एंड शुड नॉट कन्फ्यूज विथ सी नाइट्रोजन ऑक्साइड. दिस NO, I'm sorry. There is one compound called nitrogen dioxide, NO2. Nitrogen dioxide, सुने नाम? Have you heard about nitrogen dioxide? Nitric oxide and nitrogen dioxide कभी भी confused नहीं होना. कभी भी confused नहीं होना. Nitric oxide is different and nitrogen dioxide is different. Nitrogen dioxide, it is a poison. Nitrogen dioxide is a pollutant. It is a pollutant actually. अपने हवा में इंडस्ट्रीज के से पूरा पोल्यूशन निकलता ना, उसके अंदर नाइट्रोजन डाइऑक्साइड बहुत ज़्यादा रहता. एंड देर इज वन मोर कंपाउंड विच इज कॉल्ड नाइट्रस ऑक्साइड. नाइट्रस ऑक्साइड, सुने नाम, नाइट्रस ऑक्साइड, N2O, नाइट्रस ऑक्साइड. ओके, यू शुड नॉट कन्फ्यूज विथ NO, N2O एंड NO2. ओके, सो दिज आर Actually, this N2O and NO2 are not at all related with neurotransmitters. But in neurotransmitters, yaad rakhlo, nitrous oxide, not nitrous oxide. NO is nitric oxide. Nitric oxide and carbon monoxide, CO, carbon monoxide and H2S, hydrogen sulfide. Okay, so these are न्यूरोट्रांसमीटर्स, गैशियस न्यूरोट्रांसमीटर्स विच आर सीन इन द बॉडी. अब देखो, न्यूरोट्रांसमीटर्स के बारे में क्लासिफिकेशन पूरा अपने को एक ब्रीफ आइडिया आ गया, राइट? आई थिंक यू ऑल गॉट द बेसिक आइडिया ऑफ न्यूरोट्रांसमीटर्स. यस आर नो एवरीबडी? यस आर नो? अब देखो, सब लोग ध्यान से सुनो. देर आर सम सी एन एस डिसऑर्डर्स. इन सी एन एस डिसऑर्डर्स पर्टिकुलरली वी हैव नंबर वन एक्साइटेशंस एंड वी हैव डिप्रेशन. अभी अपन देखे CNS के अंदर, CNS स्टिमुलेशन के वजह से क्या क्या होता, ऑल डिफरेंट थिंग्स वी हैव सीन. एंड इन CNS डिप्रेशन वी हैव सीन ऑल ड्राउजीनेस, सेडेशन, हिप्नोसिस, ऑल वी हैव सीन. अलॉन्ग विथ दिस, CNS सिस्टम के अंदर पेशेंट विल बी हैविंग एपिलेप्सी. एपिलेप्सी इज वन डिसऑर्डर. एपिलेप्सी patient will have, narcolepsy patient will have, schizophrenia patient will have, parkinsonism. और क्या है CNS disorders में, क्या क्या है, anybody? Yes, और क्या miss हो गए? But everything comes under excitations and depressions. Okay, तो ये these are all, और याद आए तो वो पूरे detail में देखेंगे बाद में, but this is, I'm just trying to give you overview of CNS disorders. And see, in CNS disorders we have sleep disorders. This is very, very important. Sleep disorders. Okay. In sleep disorders, yaad rakhlo sab log, sleep disorder ke andar, what is the main sleep disorder which is seen in patient is number one, इनसोमनिया इनसोमनिया नहीं सोऊंगा इनसोमनिया नहीं सोऊंगा ओके एंड नंबर टू नंबर टू नंबर टू देयर इज अनदर स्लीप डिसऑर्डर व्हिच इज कॉल्ड हाइपरसोमनिया 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 व्हिच इज आल्सो कॉल्ड नार्कोलेप्सी हैव यू हर्ड अबाउट नार्कोलेप्सी हैव यू हर्ड अबाउट नार्कोलेप्सी सही बोला नार्कोलेप्सी 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 बोले सो नार्कोलेप्सी बोले तो क्या हाइपर हाइपरसोमनिया दिन भर सोते रहता रात भर सोते रहता क्लास में सोते रहता प्लेग्राउंड के अंदर सोते रहता दे आर कंसिडर्ड एज हाइपरसोमनिक पेशेंट्स एंड देर इज थर्ड स्लीप डिसऑर्डर कोई बोलते थर्ड स्लीप डिसऑर्डर एनीबडी फ्रॉम द क्लास कैन एनीबडी टेल मी देर इज अ कंडीशन कॉल्ड नॉक्टर्नल नॉक्टर्नल और नॉक्ट्यूरल नॉक्टर्नल एन्यूरिसिस एन्यूरिसिस वॉट इज नॉक्टर्नल एन्यूरिसिस एनीबडी फ्रॉम द क्लास जागना नॉक्टर्नल एन्यूरिसिस नॉक्टर्नल डायूरिसिस नॉक्टर्नल एन्यूरिसिस एनीबडी फ्रॉम द क्लास नॉक्टर्नल एन्यूरिसिस क्या है एनीबडी बीच बीच में जागना वेरी गुड और नॉक्टर्नल एन्यूरिसिस बोलो व्हाट यू नो अबाउट नॉक्टर्नल एन्यूरिसिस नॉक्टर्नल एन्यूरिसिस मींस समटाइम्स पेशेंट विल हैव बेड वेटिंग बेड वेटिंग बेड वेटिंग मींस नींद में मुद्दे था पेशेंट पेशेंट विल यूरिनेट इन sleep itself that is called nocturnal enuresis actually chote jab apan chote chote rehte the due to involuntary actions in small age that is common but even in adults also some people will have this condition so it is not normal nocturnal enuresis is not normal it is sleep disorder is three sleep disorders mein apne ko drugs hai we have very 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 effective drugs we have very effective drugs for sleep disorders so see if anybody is having sleep disorder If anybody is having sleep disorder, we have certain drugs. Before understanding about drugs, see in insomnia actually we have different types. Insomnia के अंदर भी different types है. कभी कभी अपने को भी insomnia आते रहता. There is one type of insomnia called transient insomnia. सुने नाम कभी? Transient insomnia. Have you heard about? There is a movie called Trance. हाँ, देखे आप लोग. How many of you have seen that Trance movie? It is a good movie. Fahal Fazad ka kya ho sana. Anyways, chalo dekho. Insomnia. In insomnia, we have three categories. Number one, transient insomnia. We have short term insomnia, and we have long term insomnia. So transient insomnia, kisko bolte? Short term insomnia, kisko bolte? Long term insomnia, kisko bolte? Listen everybody. Listen very carefully. Transient insomnia is said to that patients. Who doesn't get sleep up to 3 days from hours to 3 hours to days up to 3 days agar patient ko neend nahi aaya usko transient insomnia bolte 3 din ke baad fir neend aa gaya to usko transient insomnia hi bolte till 3 days if patient is not getting sleep from 3 days to 3 weeks they are considered as short term insomnic patients and if patient is not sleeping more than 3 weeks they are considered as long term insomnic that means din bhar raat bhar aise jagde nahi rehte beech beech mein neend nahi aati wo logon ko beech beech mein neend nahi aati continuously for 3 days if that occurs they are said to be transient insomnic if patient is having that symptom from 3 days to 3 weeks every day patient is waking up and patient is unable to sleep at night till 3 weeks agar aisa continue hua then we will consider them as short term insomnic patients एंड 3 वीक से ज़्यादा ऐसा कंटिन्यू हुआ तो दे आर वेरी क्रॉनिक लॉन्ग टर्म इंसोमनिक पेशेंट्स इसमें कंपलसरी ट्रीटमेंट शुरू कर देना अपन एंड यहाँ पे ट्रीटमेंट कंपलसरी देना एंड दे आर कंसिडर्ड एज वेरी लीथल कंडीशंस ओके ये इसमें बहुत दूसरे सिम्टम्स भी रहेंगे पेशेंट को हेड एक पेशेंट विल हैव डायरिया पेशेंट विल हैव मजल पेन मजल ट्विचेस वो सब रहते ओके एनीवेज इसके बारे में डिटेल में बाद में बात करेंगे अब देखो इन स्लीप डिसऑर्डर्स वी हैव इंसोमनिया हाइपरसोमनिया and nocturnal enuresis in insomnia we have 3 types transient short term and long term clear see how many of you know what is sleep and stages of sleep because here now we will try to start with barbiturates benzodiazepines we have sedatives narcotics wo sab drugs abhi aayenge isliye we should learn all these basic things how many of you know about the stages of sleep anybody from the class How many of you know about the stages of sleep? Anybody from the class? अरे बोलो, आर यू ऑल फॉलोइंग मी? हाँ तो बोलो, क्वेश्चन क्या था? यू माइट हैव हर्ड स्टेजेस ऑफ स्लीप, कौन कौन सुने हैं? हाउ मेनी ऑफ यू हर्ड अबाउट स्टेजेस ऑफ स्लीप? एनीबडी फ्रॉम द क्लास? जैनब, जैनब, फोर स्टेजेस, फोर स्टेजेस. ओके ओके, लिजन 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 एवरीबडी. सी एक्चुअली इन स्लीप वी हैव टू टाइप्स ऑफ स्लीप्स. एक्चुअली इन दैट वी हैव रैंडम आई मूवमेंट स्लीप, रैंडम आई मूवमेंट, एंड वी हैव नॉन रैंडम आई मूवमेंट स्लीप, और सिंपली वी कैन से रेम स्लीप एंड नॉन रेम स्लीप, रेम स्लीप एंड नॉन रेम स्लीप. अब सुनो सब लोग, सब लोग ध्यान से सुनना, यहाँ पे सब लोग ध्यान से सुनना. इनिशियली व्हेन वी स्टार्ट स्लीपिंग, 11 बजे, 11:30 बजे, 12 बजे जब अपन सोना शुरू होते, स्लोली फ्रॉम 1 to 5 मिनट्स, 5 to 10 मिनट्स के अंदर नींद आ जाता. ओके, आफ्टर 5 to 10 मिनट्स, आफ्टर 5 to 10 मिनट्स इमिडिएटली पेशेंट विल गो टू स्टेज वन स्लीप. स्टेज वन, पेशेंट विल गो टू स्टेज वन, एंड पेशेंट विल बी एट स्टेज वन फ्रॉम 5 to 15 मिनट्स और 5 to 30 मिनट्स. इट डिपेंड्स फ्रॉम पेशेंट टू पेशेंट. पेशेंट पहले स्टेज वन पे रहता. स्टेज वन पे क्या है, पेशेंट इज नॉट टोटली इन डीप स्लीप, नॉर नॉट पेशेंट इज डायरेक्टली अवेक. अवेक अवेक नहीं रहता या डीप स्लीप में नहीं रहता, मिडिल में रहता. दैट इज स्टेज वन. एंड फ्रॉम स्टेज वन, सो दिस स्टेज वन इज यूजली प्रेजेंट फ्रॉम 5 मिनट्स टू 15 मिनट्स. उसके बाद स्लोली पेशेंट विल गो टू डीप स्लीप, विच इज कॉल्ड स्टेज टू. वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. सेकेंड स्टेज क्या है, डीप स्लीप बोलते हैं इसको. एंड डीप स्लीप यूजुअली अपने को स्लीप के अंदर सबसे ज़्यादा टाइम अपन डीप स्लीप के अंदर ही स्पेंड करते हैं. ओके, फर्स्ट स्टेज पे क्या था, फर्स्ट स्टेज पे क्या था, इनिशियली पेशेंट स्टार्टेड विथ स्लीप 15 to 20 मिनट्स, 15 to 30 मिनट्स जो भी है. एंड आफ्टर दैट पेशेंट वेंट टू डीप स्लीप, एंड डीप स्लीप मेजॉरिटी ऑफ टाइम वी विल बी स्पेंडिंग इन स्टेज टू. एंड आफ्टर स्टेज टू, स्टेज टू 1 घंटा 2 घंटे 3 घंटे 4 घंटे के बाद स्लोली पेशेंट विल अगेन गो टू स्टेज थ्री. पेशेंट विल गो टू स्टेज थ्री. स्टेज थ्री इज द स्टेज वेयर पेशेंट इज बिटवीन डीप स्लीप एंड नॉन डीप स्लीप, बीच में रहता. एंड दिस ऑल्सो विल बी फ्रॉम 30 to 40 मिनट्स. उसके बाद पेशेंट विल गो टू स्टेज फोर. स्टेज फोर, यहाँ पे स्टेज फोर में डीप स्लीप में नहीं रहता. स्टेज फोर इज द स्टेज वेयर पेशेंट कैन अवेकन, पेशेंट कैन ईजिली अवेकन इफ एनी बडी टचेस हिम और इफ एनी साउंड कम्स. छोटा मोटा कुछ साउंड आ गया ना तो तुरंत उठ जाता पेशेंट. सेकेंड स्टेज से उठेगा क्या पेशेंट? सेकेंड नहीं, थर्ड स्टेज में थोड़ा बहुत अवेकेंड रह सकता है, बट फोर्थ स्टेज पे सडनली उठ जाता पेशेंट. ओके, फोर्थ स्टेज इज द स्टेज वेयर पेशेंट विल बी स्टेइंग आफ्टर थर्ड स्टेज. आई मीन इसका यहाँ पे अगेन 5 to 15 मिनट्स के बीच में रहता है. 5 to 15 मिनट्स रहता, फिर वहाँ से फिर स्टेज वन को चले जाता पेशेंट. उठने के बाद फिर स्टेज वन को जाता, स्टेज वन से टू, टू से फिर थ्री, थ्री से फिर फोर. समझ गए, नॉन रैंडम आई मूवमेंट स्लीप बोलते हैं इसको. इन नॉन रैंडम आई मूवमेंट स्लीप वी हैव फोर स्टेजेस. अब देखो, देर इज अनदर टाइप ऑफ स्लीप विच इज कॉल्ड रैंडम आई मूवमेंट स्लीप. रैंडम आई मूवमेंट स्लीप विल बी कमिंग बिटवीन स्टेज टू एंड थ्री, हियर समटाइम्स, हियर एंड समटाइम्स, हियर एंड समटाइम्स आफ्टर फोर्थ स्टेज ऑल्सो. याद रख लो सब लोग, रैंडम आई मूवमेंट विल बी कमिंग बिटवीन 2 to 3, 3 to 4 और 4 to 5, बीच बीच में आता. एंड इट विल स्टे 2 to 5 मिनट्स, 2 to 5 मिनट्स ही रहता वो रैंडम आई मूवमेंट. 2 to 5 मिनट्स रहता. एंड इन दिस पेशेंट विल हैव रैपिड रैंडम आई मूवमेंट्स. पेशेंट विल हैव रैपिड रैंडम आई मूवमेंट्स. एंड यहाँ पे एक्चुअली रैंडम आई मूवमेंट इज द प्लेस वेयर पेशेंट पेशेंट विल बी सीइंग सम पेशेंट विल बी सीइंग सम डेंजरस इंसिडेंसेस और डेंजरस ड्रीम्स और चेजिंग चेजिंग और किलिंग और डइंग और फॉलिंग फ्रॉम द माउंटेन्स और ये सब रहते उसमें. पेशेंट पेशेंट क्या करते रहता, पेशेंट्स आई विल बी मूविंग मूविंग रैंडमली. पेशेंट्स हार्ट रेट विल बी इंक्रीज, पेशेंट्स परस्परेशन विल बी इंक्रीज. ओके, एंड पेशेंट विल बी एक्साइटेड एट द टाइम. एंड सडनली क्या होता है, एक बार रैंडम मूवमेंट से सडनली एक बार पेशेंट उठ जाता. सडनली क्या करता पेशेंट, उठ जाता. उठ करे क्या हो रहा मेरे को, व्हाट्स हैपनिंग. एंड सडनली इफ इफ पेशेंट रिकॉल्स द ड्रीम, अरे इट वॉज ए ड्रीम करके फिर से नॉर्मलाइज होकर फिर से सो जाता. एंड पेशेंट विल कंटिन्यू फ्रॉम स्टेज वन, स्टेज टू, स्टेज थ्री, स्टेज फोर. अंडरस्टूड एवरीबडी वॉट इज रैंडम आई मूवमेंट एंड वॉट इज नॉन रैंडम आई मूवमेंट? नॉन रैंडम आई मूवमेंट में फोर स्टेजेस वी हैव. क्लियर एवरीबडी? इसमें भी बहुत सारे स्टडीज अभी चाहिए जो मेरे को समझ में आया है, दैट आई एक्सप्लेन दिस ऑल थिंग्स आई स्टडीड इन माई साइकोलॉजी क्लासेस, सो वाट आई अंडरस्टूड आई एम एक्सप्लेनिंग यू. उसमें थोड़ा बहुत आगे पीछे भी हो सकता है, बट दैट डजेंट मैटर बिकॉज इट इज़ नॉट क्लियर इन एनी टेक्स्ट बुक, इट इज़ नॉट क्लियर. बट मेनी टेक्स्ट बुक्स वाट दे से, दे एक्सप्लेन अबाउट रैंडम आई मूवमेंट एंड नॉन रैंडम आई मूवमेंट, एंड इन नॉन रैंडम आई मूवमेंट वी हैव फोर स्टेजेस, दैट्स इट. क्लियर अबाउट द स्टेजेस ऑफ स्लीप, स्टेजेस ऑफ स्लीप? ओके, अब देखो अगर किसी भी पेशेंट को इन स्लीप डिसऑर्डर, इफ पेशेंट इज हैविंग इनसोमनिया, इफ पेशेंट इज हैविंग इनसोमनिया, वॉट काइंड ऑफ ड्रग्स विल बी गिवन टू द पेशेंट? इफ पेशेंट इज हैविंग इनसोमनिया, वॉट काइंड ऑफ ड्रग्स विल बी गिवन टू द पेशेंट? इनसोमनिया मेन क्लिनिकल प्रेजेंटेशन कहां पर आता? इनसोमनिया क्लिनिकल प्रेजेंटेशन कहां पर आता? विच न्यूरो ट्रांसमीटर्स आर कॉजिंग इनसोमनिया? आई थिंक यू शुड टेल मी दिस आंसर. When patient is having excitatory neurotransmitter overactivity, excitatory neurotransmitter में glutamate बोले, aspartate, वो time पे patient को क्या होगा? CNS stimulant होगा, and in CNS stimulants insomnia is the one clinical presentation. No, excitation, elation, agitation, insomnia is also one clinical presentation in excitatory neurotransmitter. So see, if anybody is having insomnia, simply we have some drugs called sedatives, we have some drugs called hypnotics, okay, and we have some CNS depressants. Actually sedatives and hypnotics are also CNS depressants. Iske sath dusre bhi hai. In sedatives are those drugs which will try to decrease the excitation of the patient. Simply sedatives kya karte fatafat bolo. Sedatives will try to decrease the excitation of the patient. And hypnotics are the drugs which will cause hypnosis, or which will cause normal sleep. Sedatives normal sleep nahi karte. Sedatives kya karte? Excitation kam karte. But hypnotics kya karte? Direct sleep cause karte the. Sedatives are decreasing excitation, hypnotics are causing hypnosis, or they will cause normal sleep. And CNS depressants, they will cause both sedative, hypnotics, they will cause all muscle relaxation. CNS depression mein jo bhi padhe apan, wo sab drowsiness, disorientation, wo sab karenge. Okay? So in sedatives, hypnotics and CNS depressants, we have barbiturates, we have benzodiazepines, okay? And we have some tricyclic antidepressants, and we have some opioids. So these are all the drugs which will be used for sedatives, hypnotics, and CNS depressants. If patient has insomnia, ये barbiturates, benzodiazepines, tricyclic antidepressants detail में पढ़ते हैं अपन. अब next we are going to study about these drugs in detail about their pharmacokinetics and pharmacodynamics. Clear? Now you see, there is another sleep disorder. Just now I told there is another sleep disorder called hypersomnia. अगर किसी भी patient में hypersomnia है तो आप क्या treatment दोगे? What treatment will you go with hypersomnic patients? Yes, anybody from the class? What treatment will be given to hypersomnic patients? Anybody from the class? CNS stimulants, very good. CNS stimulants. In CNS stimulants, what we have? Just now I told amphetamines, armodafinil, modafinil. Did I tell cocaine? Not cocaine. Cocaine nahi dete. It is having more addictive property. Methylphenidate. Did I tell all these drugs? So in that, mainly there are some drugs called amphetamines. Amphetamines are very older drugs and very famous drugs. किसी भी पेशेंट में हाइपरसोमनिया है तो amphetamines देते, methamphetamine, amphetamine and amphetamine derivatives. ये भी बहुत देख समझ के देना, इसके बारे में मैं डिटेल में समझाऊंगा आपको. ओके, सो टिल नाउ आई थिंक वी हैव कवर्ड ऑल बेसिक पॉइंट्स. टिल नाउ वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट ऑल बेसिक पॉइंट्स. नाउ वी विल ट्राई टू डिस्कस, वी विल स्टार्ट विद बारबिट्यूरेट्स. शैल आई स्टार्ट बारबिट्यूरेट्स, और यू वॉन्ट मी टू स्टार्ट इन नेक्स्ट क्लास?